In this video, we're going to be taking a look at linear regression. And basically what linear regression has to do with is finding a line of best fit for the data. Now it turns out, despite the fact that best seems to imply that there is only one, there's a bunch of different ways to find lines of quote-unquote best fit for a data set. And the one that your book focuses on is linear regression, this process, which sometimes you will also hear referred to as the least squares line, or using the method of least squares. So we'll talk about why this term least squares, where does that come from? So I want to give you the theory behind this first. Then I want to show you how to find it in the calculator, and then I want to talk to you a little bit about the things that we can use the linear regression line for. So first I'm going to grab us some data. Let me find some here. So this is some data looking at comparing the weight of a car to the miles per gallon that that car gets. And so our x variable is the weight of a car in hundreds of pounds. And so we have 27, 44, 32, 47, 23, 40, 34, and 52. So there's the weights of the car. And then the y variable here is representing the miles per gallon that the car gets. So we've got 30, and then 19, 24, 13, 29, 17, 21, and 14. Okay, so there's what we've got. And the first thing that we might want to do is we might want to actually create, let's do a part A, where we create a scatter diagram of the data. Because we might be interested in what does this data set actually look like? Does it even look linear? Does it make sense to try and fit a straight line to it? So here we will, got some old stuff in here. Let me clear it out. Go into the calculator, put the lists, the data into two lists. Again, you want your x data in one list, so I'm going to put it in list 1, 27, 44, 32, 47, 23, 40, 34, and 52. And then we want our y data in a second list, so 30, 19, 24, 13, 29, 17, 21, and 14. Okay, so we've got our data in there. Into two lists. And again, remember to create the scatter plot here, or the scatter diagram, we go to second y equals, select a plot by pressing enter, make sure it's turned on, make sure your scatter plot is selected, L1 and L2 if that's where your data are stored, pick a mark to use, I'm just going to use a little square there, and do zoom 9 to let the calculator zoom in on it. And here's the data that we're seeing. So we can see that there does appear to be a trend in the data set. It is a roughly linear trend, and it appears to be a negative relationship. So that tells us that as x increases, as the weight of the car increases, the y values, or the miles per gallon, tend to decrease. Which makes a lot of sense, right? Heavier cars use more fuel just to propel themselves. So we would expect, in general, heavier cars to not get as many, miles per gallon. So what we're seeing here is completely consistent with what I would have expected. And if we wanted to make a brief sketch of this, here's our x, here's our y. Again, here we would want weight in, what did I say this was, hundreds of pounds? Yep, hundreds of pounds. And this is the miles per gallon up the side. So we've got, whoops, sorry. We've got that. And then we could make just a little sketch here of what we were seeing in the data, like so. And we would, again, want to indicate scale here. So it looks like our lowest X was at around 23, so this would be at around 23 here. And then our highest X was 52. So this would be around 52 right here. And then lowest Y is 13. So this guy right here would be around 13. And then highest Y is 30. Okay, so then we've got an indication of scale. So we've got our scatter diagram. It does appear to have a negative linear trend. It would make sense in that case to go ahead and fit a straight line to this data. Now, let me tell you something about how essentially your calculator goes about fitting a straight line. If I asked you to find a line of best fit for this data and to write me an equation of that line, and if you didn't have a calculator to help you with that, what you would do is you would, plot this very neatly on graph paper, and you would slide a ruler or something like that around on the data until it looked like you had the line that got as close to as many data points as possible. Maybe it even goes through a couple of them, and you plunk that down, and then you would find the slope of that line and the intercept. The intercept is almost, the one that I've drawn, is almost at 30, and then we would calculate the slope just using the normal way that you would do that in an algebra class. That being said, if that's the method that I ask you to use, everybody in class is going to have a slightly different equation because we're all going to draw a slightly different line. And we don't want lines of best fit. We want a line of best fit. What is the one that definitively fits the data set best? So here's what your calculator does. It uses something called the method of least squares. So basically the idea is we plunk down a line, and then we look at how far off we were. Now the line doesn't go exactly through this data point. It's off by a little bit. And here we're off by a little bit. This one, it actually goes directly through. Here we're off by some. Here we're off by quite a bit. Here we're off by a little bit. Here we're off by a medium amount. And here we're off by a little bit. Okay. So we have all these little leftover bits. Those leftovers are called residuals. And whatever reason, they're given a lowercase letter e as their symbol. Okay, so each data point will have a residual value. And then what you would do to find out if this is the line that fits the data best is you would take these residuals, and since the line of best fit should be the one that gets as close to as many of the data points as possible, we might want to create a total residual value. So one thought might be to add them all up. But since some of the points fall above the line and some fall below, some of the residuals are positive and some are negative. If you add them all together as they stand, they will end up canceling out and you'll get a value of 0. So instead what we do is we square all of those residuals and add them together. And the line that minimizes the sum of the squares of the residuals is the line that fits the data best. And hence, least squares. That's why this method is called the method of least squares. We are minimizing the sums of the squares, or the sum of the squares of the residuals. Okay, that just means that this total distance that the data points fall away from the line has been minimized. There is not another line out there that would do a better job at getting closer to all of the data points. Now, certainly there is a lot of computation involved in finding this line. If you're interested in doing that, take a look at your book if you want to see how it's done by hand and how that formula is derived. But your calculator also has a program in it that will find this line for you. Okay, so that's what we're going to do here. So, part B. calculate the linear regression line, or line of best fit, or least squares line. All of those are referring to the same thing for this data. Okay. So in the last video, when we found the correlation coefficient R, we did something in the calculator called LINREG, right? We went to STAT and to CALC, and we went to option 8 LINREG here, LINREG, A plus BX. That same thing that we used just to find R also finds the equation of the line of best fit. But I'll show you how to do one extra thing here that's really handy. Not only can we have the calculator find the equation for the line of best fit, but we can also have it graph the line of best fit on the scatter plot that we created just to see how nicely everything fits. So here's how we would do that. We still want L1 comma L2, since that's where our data are stored, x comma y. And then we want one more comma. And what we're going to put in now is the place where we would like the calculator to store the line of best fit. So we've got list one, list two, comma, and then press vars, V-A-R-S, right here, next to clear. Scroll right one to yvars, press enter to select function, and press enter to select y1. So what this command will do is it will find the line of best fit for the x data in list 1, the y data in list 2, and it will store the equation of that line in your y1 under your y equals so that it will graph along with the rest of the data. Okay. So at this point we press enter. Here's the equation. I'll tell you how to interpret that now. So we've got LINREG, y equals a plus bx, and then it says our a is this, about 43.33, and our b is about negative 0.60. So this a value here, that is your intercept for your line. And this b value here goes right next to your x in the equation, that's the slope of the line. And your calculator doesn't put a hat on the y, but it should have a hat on it. This line will allow us to predict y values based on x's, and you always want to put a hat over values that have been predicted. Okay, so y hat is approximately equal to a, 43.33, and then it says plus bx, but our b is negative, so minus 0.60x. And that's our line of best fit for the data. If we go back and also you can see here our R value, our correlation coefficient, is about negative 0.95. So we can see that there is a strong negative linear relationship between weight of a car and miles per gallon. Okay. Now if we go take a look at the graph, if we go back to the graph, because we put that Y1 in there, it will superimpose the graph on here for us. And we can see what a nice job it's done of drawing in there and taking a look at that. So that's how we calculate the line of best fit. What can we do with this? A couple of things. We can interpret the slope and the intercept in the context of the problem. We'll talk about that. And then we can also use this line to make predictions. So we'll talk about that as well in the next video.